really want to focus on is to give you a framework to understand the phenomena of the most massive migration to the United States in a variety of ways, in terms of various flows. And that's from Mexico, and now also more recently from other countries. For the first time, Mexican immigration has been outnumbered by immigrants from other countries. But we have an experience here of over 100 years of movement. This is not a kind of migration like Italian or Irish migration that was dominant for 30 years or 40 years and then ended. We're talking about over a century of movements. And I want to let you know how these movements started across borders. Labor migration is not permanent settler migration. And it's not accidental, it's just not a natural phenomenon that developed. And now you have people realize that there's a great labor force that's arrived in the United States, and there's a demand for that work in other parts of the country. In Nebraska, in Minnesota, in Indiana, in Michigan, in Washington, in other states, different regions of the country. And so you have this territorial migration and movement of workers, and some people begin to settle. They're employed there. They're mainly seasonal agricultural workers, but they get employed to work in other sectors of the economy. And began to settle as well. So you have a multiplicity of migrant flows now. Legal immigration, illegal migration, contract labor migration, temporary labor migration, border commuter migration. So the whole system becomes more complex.